Pre-pro-postbiotics. What are they and what can they do for your skin? Well, to understand that, you need to first learn about the skin's microbiome. And I did a video on that I'm going to link up in the cards now and that I recommend you watch first before you come back to this video. But if you're all set up, let's go. Hi, I'm Dr. Anne. I'm a medical doctor with a passion for skincare that works. On this channel, we explore the science behind skin and do quick reviews, so you learn to pick exactly those products that work for your individual skin concern. So if this is something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and ring the notification bell. Pre, pro and postbiotics have been increasingly popular in skincare, and today I want to talk to you about what these actually are and how they can or cannot be beneficial in your skincare. Let's talk about prebiotics first. Prebiotics have actually been around in nutrition for quite some time, and they refer to all the non-digestible food sources that our gut microbiome, or the good bacteria in our gut, need to flourish. These are things like fiber, certain sugars, and you probably have all seen them, these prebiotic drinks that you can shake up. They have been around for more than 20 years now. But just to put it out there, even though there are some data that suggest that a diet rich in prebiotics can help the gut microbiome stay healthy, there is no exact measurements which one of them need to be consumed in which amounts to have X amount of benefit. If you now transfer that to the skin, where the microbiome still needs a lot more research than the gut microbiome, you can probably already guess that these prebiotics, or the food for the bacteria on your skin that you can get in skincare, might be beneficial, are certainly not harmful, but really don't have much data behind them. So if you buy something that says it contains prebiotics, it means that it contains things that are beneficial for the bacteria on your skin to flourish and grow, the good bacteria. And as I said in the last video, we don't really know exactly what the good and bad bacteria are. I mean, we know a few that are certainly bad and a few that are certainly good, but so far, this is an area of research, and while there have been promising results in patients with atopic dermatitis, for example, I think it's still too soon to expect wonders from them in skincare. Moving on to probiotics. Probiotics, by definition, are actually live microorganisms. And as you probably can guess, live microorganisms are pretty difficult to get in either with your nutrition or with your skincare, because with your nutrition, most microorganisms that are not encapsulated in a special way are killed off in your stomach, because that's what it's for. And in your skincare, well, no one wants a pot of cream that is overgrowing with microorganisms. And while when it comes to gut health, we have things like fecal transplantation, that I'm not going to go into much detail here, that can actually transfer a live microbiome from one person's gut to another person's gut, we don't really have the same in skincare. Next thing is that growing microorganisms in a skincare product are per definition contamination and lead to a recall, and that the preservatives that we use in our skincare has the one purpose to hinder microorganisms from growing and kill any microorganisms that come into the pot. So yeah, there's not much chance of you actually getting a live bacteria with any of your skincare product. I think Mother Dirt is the only company that found kind of a loophole with that, but usually if you read probiotic on your skincare, what they're actually referring to are postbiotics. And what postbiotics are is what I'm going to explain to you now. Postbiotics are the leftovers of no longer live bacteria. It's like Bifidus lusat or Bifidus ferment, the whole fermented ingredients thing, because fermentation and lysation means that the bacteria is transformed, it is killed, it's no longer alive, and that all the nutrients that are inside the microbial cell are set free. It's like, yeah, you wring out the inside of the microorganism and take what's in there after you ripped open their membranes. Sounds pretty harsh like that, but yeah, it's just bacteria. These postbiotics have shown to have antioxidant effects and hydrating effects, which is why many people really enjoy fermented skincare ingredients. I have personally not used much fermented skincare, but it's huge in the whole Korean beauty and Asian trend, and many people see great benefits from it. So if you purchase a product and it says probiotics and you turn it around and it says Bifido or Saccharomyces or whatever, lysate or ferment, then you know that this is actually postbiotic and that they have a shown beneficial effect on your skin. If this is more than other antioxidants and humectants, I can't tell you, but the effect is there. So out of the three, pre might be helpful, not enough research, certainly not harmful. I'm open to trying them. Pro, you won't get real probiotics in your skincare, so. And postbiotics, yes, they are beneficial. If they're better than other things, I can't judge, but at least there's no harm in trying. I hope that cleared up some of your questions. It has actually been shown that using a moisturizer without any pre, pro, or postbiotics inside, using just a plain moisturizer in itself is beneficial for the skin microbiome, probably because it protects the skin's microbiome. So skincare is not completely useless, and the skin's microbiome is a field that gets a lot of interest and research right now. So I think it's quite possible that within the next 10 years we'll have some breakthrough discoveries there that will help us help our skin's microbiome. Until then, treat your skin gentle. More tips are in the microbiome video that are linked in the cards. And yeah, I'm going to link to more videos of Ask Dr. Anne series on the screen now. And I'm going to see you all very soon with another one. Bye.